maybe you'd like to learn a little bit more about Hollyweird, La La Land, the movies that have come out of us here in LA. And I have Mark Ramsey with us, who's doing the podcast Inside Jaws. It's another season of a lot of different films, and I think it's appropriate we have the beach behind us. You've done The Exorcist, now we're on Jaws. Why look into Jaws for your subject this season?
Well, first of all, Jaws is like the ultimate tentpole movie, right? It was the original tentpole movie. It's the reason why we have tentpole movies today. So it's part of everyone's childhood.
Right.
It's really more about Steven Spielberg and his creation as the Steven Spielberg we know today. So we start with Spielberg as kind of the dejected, lonely kid in Phoenix,
right,
who transforms into the guy he is today, primarily because of that transition point of Jaws. That's the fulcrum on which his career changed utterly. And it's such an irresistible story. And it's a classic. It's funny because it's a classic Steven Spielberg movie, and it's also a classic Steven Spielberg story.
Absolutely. And looking at the beach behind us, no kid, even if you aren't familiar with the movie, you've never watched it, say you're 10 years old right now, you know Jaws. You know what the theory is about this shark lurking in the waters below. You can't go in there without thinking about it. But you dive into less on the psychology of being scared of sharks and more about the filmmaking. And I think we should emphasize that because this is so much more than a shark podcast.
Yeah, it's close to Shark Week,
yeah,
but
sure.
It's not really, that we do kind of recreate some of the inspiration stories for Jaws, their shark attacks from New Jersey in 1916. And also there's a story that's central to Jaws about the sinking of a naval ship
right. And
how many of the sailors were eaten by sharks. So we go into all that. But really it's a story about this kid who has to find himself and finds himself when he's directing this amazing movie and becomes the legendary director we know today. And it's really not like a director's commentary at all.
No.
It's much more of a hero story.
I think when you hear Inside Jaws, you do think it might be a director's cut. And
yeah.
I think we're going to emphasize that's not quite what it is.
One of my working titles for it was Becoming Spielberg.
Oh
yeah, so here's my question for you, Mark. What's the process like to kind of delve into someone who is iconic as Steven Spielberg is? Like, what is the research that you started to look into? And also then, how did you decide on that title, which made me think we were going inside of a shark?
Well, the title, let me answer the second question first.
Sure.
It's part of a series, and this is the third season of this series. The first season was Inside Psycho, Inside The Exorcist, and now Inside Jaws. So for that reason, we've just got that association. But I had to do tons of research. Mm-hmm. I had to read tons of books, look at tons of things online. And I had to really try and understand what drove him to his destination. And when you go back to his origin and you understand that here's this kid that didn't fit in, and you recognize that this is not just Steven Spielberg's story, this is the story of every geeky kid who has ever liked geeky things. Comic-Con's going on right now in San Diego.
Yes.
Every single person at that event can appreciate this story. Every single person is living this story. They may not reach his, you know, illustrious stature,
sure,
but they understand where he came from and where he's going, and that's why this thing is so universal.
Yeah.
Scott, let's just take a look at Inside Jaws with a little teaser of the podcast.
All right.
He has lived unchanged, perfect, for millennia. He has been called the most frightening animal on Earth. Swift, relentless, mysterious, unpredictable. He can shatter the hull of a boat. He can leap from the water and hang in midair, a swirling black and white death. It is as if God created the devil and gave him Jaws. This is the story of a movie and its inspirations. The story of a modest thriller that became an ordeal, and then a disaster, and then a phenomenon, and then a classic. I'm Mark Ramsey. From Wondery, this is Inside Jaws. Subscribe to Inside Jaws for free.
I know.
I almost bailed out of that. I almost cut out of it. I heard the sounds and I saw the,
Can I just say
spooky.
That last line?
Yep.
It's as if God created the devil and gave him jaws. That's from the original trailer for the movie, the original movie.
Sure.
And it's one of those indelible lines. So I had to appropriate that one line.
Oh, you had to.
Yeah.
Because we're so close to the universal lot here. So listening to this, I drive past it every day to get to work. Listening to Spielberg's story, you talk about how he was sneaking onto the lot to mm-hmm. meet people, to make connections. I just love that it's more than just the shark. It is about how Spielberg came to be who he is. Right now, as of today, there are 2 episodes left to be released.
Right.
So if you want to start binging now, you'll get caught up with the rest of us within the next couple weeks. And it's summer. So why not talk about Jaws?
It's the perfect thing to talk about now. I know, it's great.
And you and I were talking before we started taping about how podcasting has let people get into their creative side in a way that we couldn't do 10 years ago. And let's say you wanted to tell Spielberg's story, you would have had to make this a movie, you would have had to make
right.
this a TV show, but instead you can use audio effects, which are beautifully done in this podcast, mm-hmm. and you're telling a story that you're passionate about.
Absolutely.
Which we wouldn't have been able to see this come
no.
to fruition.
And that audio work is a function of my amazing sound designer, Jeff Schmidt, who is just incredible. But yeah, I mean, it's like any new category of stuff. When YouTube appeared, there were all these YouTube stars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now audio is a thing, and there are all these people who are creating great work in audio. And what I'm finding is it's becoming of interest to people in the larger entertainment community
sure.
who say, I have a movie project. I've been trying to make it for 10 years. Maybe I should start it as a podcast,
yep.
and that will generate interest in it, and now I can leverage it into something else.
So tell us about Mark Ramsey, the person. How'd you get into this?
I've been working in the audio space all my career, from the radio side to now the podcast side. And my interest has always been kind of the power of audio to move people. You know, people ask, well, why do you do this at all? And the answer is because I feel like we can actually move people. You know, we can scare people. We mm-hmm. can delight people. We can make them laugh. We can make them cry. And we can do all that with this medium that, you know, people associate with radio. They say, well, it's in the background, I'm driving, I'm doing something else. It's not that big a deal to me, right? I'm not that invested in it. And here we have this thing which actually is people seek out.
Right.
They want to binge, and it changes them in a meaningful way. It makes them think differently, and that's why I do it.
So Mark, then, I mean, you can see it right now with the earbuds. Do you think that kind of the advancements in audio technology, as far as being able to have a stack of shows that you can just kind of rip through, or the fact that now, I mean, you could have some really nice expensive headphones that can really put you kind of in a world away. From your audio perspective, has that technology also made it a much more kind of immersive experience?
Yes, I think so, absolutely. I mean, first of all, now it's mobile because everyone's listening on their smartphones and so on. And a lot of people have earbuds, a lot of people have headphones.
Yeah.
And again, my sound designer, Jeff Schmidt, says, you've got to use headphones.
Yes.
Because it changes everything. And he tells me that, and he does a lot of this work, that the work on Inside Jaws is more thorough, it's more immersive than about 95, 96, 97% of any podcast you can listen to, and certainly any radio show. In fact, you can go back to like classic radio shows, radio drama shows. None of them are as elaborate as this.
This
is really a movie.
Yeah.
This is a movie.
It is a movie.
I wrote this and we produced this as television without pictures.
It absolutely is. And I was telling you, you know, it's, you know, the sign of a good podcast when you're listening in the car, but when you get out of the car, you keep it going on your phone. You put it on the counter while you're doing your dishes. You're still in the house and you have a TV. You have Apple TV. You have Amazon. You have Netflix. You have all this stuff, but you choose the audio.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that says a lot about a podcast when somebody's willing to take it with them even
yeah.
after they get out of the car.
Yeah.
Sure.
And so, Mark, then here's a question for you. What is the kind of, what do you have like tips or thoughts on what makes a good kind of audio experience for someone, say they're interested in maybe starting a podcast, or if they're kind of, you know, there's so many out there, it's hard to kind of know what's good and what's not. So are there some things from your professional opinion where it's like, I've heard this, or it sounds like this, or I can tell that this is going on and this will be good?
That's a great question. And because, you know, too often people focus on, well, what's the technology I should use?
Right.
How, you know, what are the best practices? How do I get more people to listen?
Yeah.
You should focus less on how to get more people to listen and focus more on what you expect them to listen to. And the real question is, what's the content that's so compelling that you, it has to be unavoidable for you.
Right.
That it has to be in my way, that I'm actually going to tell somebody about, that I'm going to share with somebody else, that I'm going to look forward to a new episode. Mm-hmm. I'm getting notes from people saying, I hate the idea of this ending. And that's the best kind of feedback you can get.
Yeah, that is good.
Yeah, that's going to feel good.
So, on the one hand, I feel like I need a break. But at the same time, it's really heartwarming because that's why you do it. You do it so that people love it. That's why anybody does anything. Sure. That's why you guys are doing this. Yeah. That's why people make movies and make music and make television and write books and do podcasts. It's so that an audience will embrace it, no matter how large or how small that audience is.
Now, I got sad thinking about it ending.
I know.
See?
I'm like, oh wait, that's right. There are only two episodes left.
Mark, I'm an East Coast guy, so in this podcast experience for Jaws, obviously it takes place in Cape Cod, a place near and dear to
Martha's Vineyard.
Martha's Vineyard. That's right. So near and dear to all of our East Coast hearts. Did you travel out there to kind of get the feeling of what those small towns look like?
No, it's not. The budget doesn't allow that. The folks at Wondery have been wonderful, but they're not crazy. So no, I don't do any location.
Did you go the backlot tour at Universal?
You know what? I'll say this now on your show.
Sure.
If Universal should do anything, it's give me a complimentary VIP pass. VIP tour.
Because now I want to go.
Yeah.
Because I'm getting notes from people. I haven't seen Jaws since I was a kid. I just watched it again. Mm-hmm. You made me appreciate Steven Spielberg more.
Right.
And I mean, all of this stuff, it's like, okay, I'm waiting for the call from Universal with the free pass, but it hasn't come yet.
I think that's really funny because they do talk about how awful it was to make this film. So many hurdles. It's just one thing after another. Right now in the episode, I'm listening to how Bruce closed his mouth while somebody was looking inside of it. Who was it? It's Steven and...
He brought his friend George Lucas to the set.
I didn't want to spoil it, but Lucas gets his head stuck in the shark while he's looking at Bruce. The name of Jaws.
Gets his head stuck in the shark.
So many problems, and Steven Spielberg still made Jaws.
Well, that's one of the, I think, lessons that I want to convey also, which is that, anything worthwhile is hard.
There you go.
Anything worthwhile is hard. You got to work hard. You got to fight for it. And by the way, there's no guarantee after all that, but you know that you're not going to get where you want to go if your plan is to make it easy. And this is another lesson for podcasters too.
Yeah.
If you think you're just going to drift into this stuff or just open the mic with your buddies and then have an audience of hundreds of thousands, you're sadly mistaken.
Takes a lot of work.
Bummer.
Sorry.
Bummer for my side gig.
Well, so if you're interested in going here this weekend and you want to spook yourself out before that, listen to Inside Jaws. Mark Ramsey is so beautifully telling the story of not only Jaws, but Steven Spielberg and how he came to be. And I feel like a lot of people in LA will empathize with that because the struggle is real for writers,
yes,
filmmakers, producers, actors, and a lot of that is right here in Southern California.
And it's right there on the show, too.
Absolutely. Mark, thank you so much. We can find you anywhere you can find a podcast, right?
That's right.
Apple, anywhere else. Thanks for watching, you guys, and hopefully you don't turn away from us right now to listen to the podcast. Wait until after the show. Is that okay with you?
But then binge.
But then binge.